Today I'm proud to present you our latest tool. This is our Chipmunk Battery Tool. It is a device which you can connect to a Apple MacBook battery, and it will give you lots of information from the battery. First, let me explain to you a little bit about the parts of the device. With the switches, you choose what it does, what you want it to read or what you want to modify. The push button is to go to the next step. Here, hiding underneath the screen, is a thumb wheel, which you can move to the left or the right, or you can press it in. In some screens, you can use that to zoom in on the information. This connects to little boards like this, for example, which allow you to attach batteries. There's many different kinds, depending on the kind of battery. Then here we also have the connections in case you want to connect to a battery yourself with wires. You can take the signals from here and just wire them up to the battery in any way you please. This is a banana socket for connecting a probe wire. You can use that to power up a battery if it is flat. This little board allows you to connect the flex cables in case of one of these modern batteries with a flex cable. You can use the normal Apple supplied flex cables. We do supply one with the tool. So let's try it out. As our first experiment today, I have a 14-inch MacBook Pro, and let's try and connect to the battery. The MacBook itself is quite dead. The motherboard is broken and the display is broken, but with my reasoning, at least the battery should be good. So because this is a modern battery with a flex cable, we have to use our little flex adapter board. We connect it to our little converter board using a flex cable. Apple has about a million different kinds of flex cables, but luckily they're all the same sort of-ish. There's the kind that has the contacts on the same side. Those are the cables that would normally plug in where this thing is horizontal. It would plug in from the right. And there's the cables where the contacts here, there it's at the top, but on this side it's at the bottom. Those are the cables that normally plug in from the left side, and the cable flips over like that. But the funny thing is that the pinout of the connector is the same in both cases, but reversed. My theory is that somebody at Apple or at the battery company got this wrong at one point and they just fixed the flex to solve that. So today I'll use this cable, which you can see with the plugs corresponds to the original one. I don't want to damage the original one, so I'm using my own. Close the tab. I also close the tab. And this plugs into the battery tool. As you see, immediately the tool starts reading. It tells us the model of Mac, the cycle count, the health of the battery. So this battery is 95% good. That's pretty good. Chip ID of the chip in the battery, the manufacturer of the battery. Again, the chip, but now read in a different way. It gives us lots and lots of information. Manufacture date, so it's not even old. The charge at the moment, 24%. The battery is sealed, which means it's locked. In the sealed state, you cannot change the information in the battery. If you want to change any of the information in the battery, you would have to unseal it first. Here on the health screen, it gives you the little smile, which means that the battery is good, it's happy, and there's no permanent fail condition set. So this battery is perfectly fine, there's nothing wrong with it. If you hold down the button like I'm doing now, it will hold the screen so you can read it or take a picture or whatever. When you let go of the button, it continues again. And you can also give the button a short press to click through the screens really quick. So this is the original serial number, and it shows you the model number of the battery, A2519, which is correct. And it's for a MacBook Pro 14-inch A2442, which is also correct. So it's also an easy way to see what battery is what if you don't know for whatever reason. Cycle count is 94, so this is a pretty good battery. Let's try the next battery. Inside the computer, this one does absolutely nothing. I have connected it with the flex cable. Because I'm using the flex cable with a 6-pin connector on the computer side, and here it plugs into the left, so I had to plug it in with the contact side down. So I'm using the wrong cable, but by flipping it over, I can use it anyway. Let's connect it to the Chipmunk Battery Tool and see what happens. Nothing happens. So step one is to connect the red probe lead to the positive terminal of the battery. It's the one on the outside. It's not labeled on this battery because Apple is Apple. And sure enough, the battery wakes up. Let's see what it has to say. It knows its model, it knows its serial number. The cycle count is 2 only, so this is a brand new battery. But it's giving a permanent fail error. It's looking sad and it says PF for permanent fail. So this battery is dead. And that's why inside the computer it does nothing. It's giving a lot of status messages. So the battery is not charged at all, 0% charge. And again, permanent fail. Let's see what reason it says. Oh, fuse is blown. And this means serious undervoltage. Cell undervoltage. Cell undervoltage. The cells are severely depleted. And here you can see it's wanting to be charged with 0 volts with 0 current. So effectively it's saying it doesn't want to be charged. So we probably cannot charge it. Let's try and reset the permanent failure and see what that does. We hold the probe on the battery again for a little while so that the battery has a little bit of charge so that the battery doesn't cut out on us while we're busy. So we go into mode 8, clear permanent fail. Let's see what that does. So let's read out all the parameters again and see if anything has improved. No, nothing has changed. Still permanent fail, which makes sense because with the fuse blown, yeah, we cannot unblow the fuse just by resetting the battery. Let's see if we can charge the battery. You never know. With the blown fuse, it should not charge. I have the power supply set to 12.5 volts and the current limited to 100 milliamps. So nothing dangerous can happen. Has absolutely no current flowing into the battery. So yes, the fuse is blown, but replacing the fuse would solve the problem. And we can see that the battery is essentially, let's go back to the capacity. It still has, yeah, there's only 2 cycle counts and it still has its original capacity. Yeah, it even has slightly more. It's at 102%. So other than the fuse blown, this battery is a very good battery. Somebody probably short-circuited it at one point or another, or the computer had water damage, I don't know. But something caused it to blow its fuse, and that's it. So this is a good battery, as good as new, or slightly better than new. I hope that you found it interesting to see our new Chipmunk battery tool. Here you can see what it looks like on the inside. We have these little adapter boards. You saw this one already for the batteries with a flex cable, but I also have them for different models of traditional battery. The battery tool is a tool that speaks to the battery, essentially pretending to be the computer. It's kind of the opposite of our battery simulator that we have been selling for a while now. That is a small device that pretends to be a battery. Using this, you can power the computer from the battery, but instead of the battery, it is this board that you connect to your power supply. So it gives you a way to test your computer from a battery, and the lights tell you a little bit about what's going on. So the two are each other's opposite. We're still working on the battery tool. It's almost ready. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. That way you'll stay informed about our new products. Please visit our website, www.cmizapper.com.